to our website here at Indiana University. My name is Brian Mullis. I'm the program director. And I'd like to start by taking you through what a residency might look like here at Indiana. We're in the heart of the Midwest. Unlike the undergraduate in Bloomington, the medical school is based in Indianapolis, where the residency program is based. And you would essentially spend all your time here with the option in your chief year of doing, in a way, elective, based on meeting certain expectations during your previous years. We start off with your intern year actually in boot camp. So you spend some time essentially doing home call in early evenings, but the majority of your time the first month is really just based on education, where we have faculty doing skills labs, really a host of didactics to prepare you for going into the field, so to speak. And we follow the standard ABOS recommendations or requirements for the first year, where you spend 6 months on orthopedic type rotations and 6 months on non-orthopedic type rotations. Getting into your PGY 2 year, this is where you really start getting into the heart of more orthopedic training. This is where you start to take on more responsibility. As a junior resident, you will work with senior residents and fellows in some cases, in addition to the faculty. We have a hybrid of rotations where you'll do some rotations as a mentorship, where it's one resident with one faculty member. And then we have other rotations that are more service-based, where it's a number of residents and in some cases fellows on more service-based rotation. The service-based rotations would include the VA, Riley Hospital, which is our premier children's hospital, Methodist Hospital, and Eskenazi, which are both level one adult trauma centers. Throughout the course of your 5 or 6 years, you will rotate through multiple different subspecialties. And the reason I say 5 or 6 is we do have 2 separate tracks. We have a clinical track and a research track as a separate match process. We offer that to residents who want to do a research year, so it's not something that you're forced to do, but roughly a third of our applicants apply for both, and that research year is after your PGY 2 year, where you go into the lab, you have no clinical responsibilities, and it's really geared for a student who is interested in becoming or going into academics, or wants that extra year of essentially basic science research that's hard to accomplish in a 5-year clinical track. Having said that, even on the 5-year clinical track, there is a requirement to complete at least one project, research project of publishable quality, and certainly most residents not only publish that one required research paper, but in fact most of our residents do multiple studies and multiple publications, as that helps them with their fellowship. So yeah, so roughly nationally, 90% of residents end up doing a fellowship today. We still are a little bit below that, probably closer to 80%. And I think that's because our residents, when they complete the program, are competent to go out and practice general orthopedics. They don't need to do a fellowship. Having said that, most of our residents do a fellowship. That's usually because they're going to be either going into an urban environment where they feel they need to do a fellowship to gain further subspecialized training, especially if they're going to a large market, or if they're going into academics. But roughly a resident a year just wants to go out and practice in rural Midwest, and we certainly encourage that. And I think if you ask any of our graduates, they would tell you they feel comfortable doing that. And so that's our goal, is to prepare not only general orthopedists who can go out and safely practice autonomously, if that's their goal, but we also want to give residents the tools they need to get the top fellowship of their choice, and we certainly offer that. So with all the research that's going on our campus, both basic science and clinical research, there's really a host of tools available to them to get involved in as much research as they want to do, which of course will help them as they apply to fellowship.